Good morning, children. In today's class, we are discussing about position of images formed in a concave mirror, sorry, convex mirror, where the object is at infinity as well as object anywhere on the principal axis. Why do we discuss only two positions here? Before understanding that, first of all, let us recall definition of focus of a convex mirror. For a convex mirror, let us imagine this is a convex mirror now. Parallel light ray is coming from distant object on the reflecting surface. When they hit the surface of the mirror, they can't pass through focus or they can't pass through the center of curvature. So now they get reflected back or they diverge back. So now, parallel light rays coming from these distant object, they diverge. And they appear to diverge from a point on the principal axis, and that point is called a focus. So focus is a point on principal axis from where all the parallel light rays coming from distant object appear to diverge after reflection. So this is for a convex mirror. In the case of concave mirror, just recall, there the parallel light rays do meet actually. So there is a focus is a point on principal axis where parallel light rays converge or meet after reflection. Now here they are appearing to diverge from a point on the principal axis, and that is focus. Now same diagram can be used here. When the object is at infinity, parallel light rays coming from distant object, they diverge and they appear to diverge from focus. So at focus, you get the virtual, erect and very small or diminished image at focus. So when the object is at infinity, you can get the image at focus, and image is virtual, image is erect and it's diminished. Now next question is, can I keep the object beyond C? Can I keep the object at C? So here now, keeping object at C or at focus, between focus and center of curvature is not possible, because focus and center of curvature on other sides, on the painted surface. That means now I can keep object anywhere on the principal axis only. I kept it. Now consider light ray parallel to principal axis. If a light ray is parallel to principal axis, then you can understand it will appear to diverge from focus. So this is one light ray you can draw. So by using another rule, a light ray appearing to pass through center of curvature, coming back in the same path. Only these two light rays you can draw. Now the reflected rays, they appear to meet between focus and pole of the convex mirror. So these reflected rays, where they appear to meet, they get one virtual image, virtual, erect, diminished image is formed, and always wherever you keep the object, image is formed only between focus and pole. So this is the case of a convex mirror, where a convex mirror is said to have virtual focus and it will only form virtual images. Concave mirror can form both real and virtual images, but convex mirror can produce only virtual images. Only these two diagrams, if you remember properly and if you are able to write the ray diagrams, like in the previous case, here also take focus as the midpoint of pole and center of curvature. There are only two positions, and here we have only two different diagrams for writing the position of images where the objects are kept at different places. So this is about convex mirror. In the next class, we will be discussing about uses of mirrors.